this season underway, as are we. Back with more in a minute. Welcome to Oakland. We're at Ring Central Coliseum. Opening day baseball on the show. It's the Cleveland Guardians going up against the Oakland Athletics. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. All right, partner, ready to go. Always a pleasure to get things started with you on opening day.
Well, happy new year, buddy. And anyone that's involved in baseball, even though it's not January 1st, this is the start of a new year. Every team has playoff hopes. I love this time of the year. I'm excited to get things going.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set to go now. And today's starter, Paul Blackburn.
Yeah, his ERA last year was a little worse than average, so definitely be looking for better results this season. One of the keys is just being able to have a consistent delivery and to be able to repeat that delivery so you can hit the spots that you want to hit and have a higher chance of being successful.
And now it's going to be Stephen Kwan. The pitch. In the air, left field, sizes this one up. One up, one down. Here's the Guardians lineup now. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
If they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Stepping in, Miles Straw. First pitch doesn't find the zone. One out, base is empty. Strike on the inside corner. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Definitely not a pitch location you're expecting up there as a hitter when you know the guy's got a good sinker ball. If you can get in that location, you've got to look top to bottom, and that's going to make it very difficult to hit.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
And first offering is fouled off. Struck right field, and it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. Naylor into second, and he's got a double.
He went up there and got it with two strikes. I'm not going to leave this in the umpire's hands. I'm going to be aggressive. He was in a location where he can get those arms extended that he loves to do. So nice job right there coming back in that at bat.
So man aboard. Here's Jose Ramirez. And there's a foul ball.
Well, a really good chance right here to pick up a run in the top of the first after what seemed to be a real quiet start to the inning.
Runner at second, two down here on opening day. And that's outside. And the count even, 1-1. Kicks and fires. And there's a rocket into the outfield. And they hold him at third. 90 feet away with two out.
All over that one right there. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle. Allowed him himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
So two on with two away. And next is the designated hitter, David Fry. And ball one. Down the line, flying after this one. Can't get there. This one lands foul. Naylor on third. Ramirez at first. Two out of the inning. Slice to right. Base hit. One runs in. Around third. He scores as well. And they lead by two.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of the stick.
So, runner at second, two down. Here's the catcher, Bo Naylor. In the air, left field, down the line, and that will drop foul.
He's given up a couple of runs, but the pitch count really not as high as you would think. Might be able to get through this one under 25 pitches.
Sliced hard, but foul. And it's second. Foul ball. It stays nothing and two. And a pitch. That's to third. Gets it to first. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Back after this on the show. Back here with my pal Ziggy. And on the hill in this one, Tanner Bibee. Chris is up 3 ERA for him a year ago.
Oh, and your numbers are coming in under 3 as a starting pitcher that's going out there every fourth or fifth day, taking the ball, competing against really good big league hitters. It's extremely impressive. And you wonder what he figured out last year that he can carry into this season that can help him to maintain that number or even drop it lower. We'll see, but we know he's got good stuff, and he should be really good in this one today.
The pitch.
I got a ball, one strike.
This one in the air, center field. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. One down. And time now to check out the A's lineup. Trailing by a couple of runs already, and I'm sure they'd like to erase that deficit quickly.
Yeah, you don't want to let this deficit get into your head and you're trying to just make up the difference with one swing and you really don't have the base runners on. You've got to contribute, keep the line moving, and all of a sudden you have a big inning, everything shifts, and you find yourself in the driver's seat.
Ryan Noda stands in here, leaves that one off the inside.
You have to be creative pitching against bad ball hitters. You got to add some velocity, subtract at times. Just avoiding the heart of the plate isn't always going to be enough. Guys like this can hurt you with pitches you wouldn't expect them to swing at.
And a pitch. Foul ball. Next one misses, and now 3-1. High fly ball down the left field line. Juan settles underneath it. Brings it in, and there's two away.
Batting third, the second baseman,
deck.
Zach Gelof. Up next for the A's.
Yeah. Who that in the whip? Yeah, you know this me. You can't stop my shine. I'm just doing me. Yeah, I'm gonna take a pick.
That one a little bit high. Ball one. Right-hander kicks, deals. Wouldn't chase that time. In the air, right side. Laureano makes the catch, and that is that. Now at the plate, Ryan Rocchio. Blackburn, a former All-Star, 30 years old now, a former first-round pick back in 2012. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. That's a hit, and the leadoff man aboard.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
This one lifted in the air, left field. Squeezes it.
Batting nine, the right fielder, number 10. Ramon Laureano.
Laureano comes up to hit. Laureano goes 5 feet 11 inches, hitting ninth in today's lineup, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. Blackburn checks over to first, and he's back. And a foul ball. Next offering is in for a strike.
Umpire behind the plate for us today, Boog, is Mike Fillmore, and he is a good one. He'll reward pitches on the edges a little bit, but the main thing is he doesn't keep you guessing. Once he established that a pitch is a strike, it stays that way.
Here's the 0-2. And there's a ball. Yeah, Fillmore, kind of, I don't know, you'd say maybe an umpire's umpire, but really consistent, very fair. Line drive, come on.
That at bat is a positive sign, even though it probably doesn't feel like it. You hit the ball hard, but it doesn't always work out in your favor. Sometimes a defender is there to make a play.
Stephen Kwan digs in for the Guardians. He's 0-1. This one in the air, right field. And that is that. Guardians lead one, but they're on top 2-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's a big power threat. Brent Rooker. Rooker getting the start in right. 29 years old, and he was selected for the All-Star game last year. Bybee back to work. On the ground to third. Ramirez sends it to first. That's one out in the bottom of the second.
Batting big. The left fielder. I don't wear
a cape. So here's Brown at the plate. Do you think that's just a statement? Then you're ludicrous like it's word of mouth. There's a strike. Bybee measures 6 feet 2 inches. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a changeup, and he occasionally uses a curve. Popped up. Has a beat on it. And he makes the catch. Two away.
Well, off to a great start. He's really cruising out there on the mound. He's got a chance to get through these first two innings with under 20 pitches. That could set him up to go deep into this game.
Two outs, bases empty. And now here's the A's catcher, Tyler Soderstrom. First pitch misses. Two outs, bases empty. A little out front there as he swings through it.
Then he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
And a foul ball. And a 1-2. And another ball. Hard hit, right side. Whips it to first. Oakland goes quietly. And 1-2-3 go the A's. They trail things here 2-0. Back here in the East Bay. All set for the start of the inning. Stepping up for the Guardians. Miles Straw. Blackburn back to work. Just missed. A little bit high. And now 2-0.
Well, he looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
At the belt and fires. Headed down the line. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. The 2-1. On the ground to third. Tosses to first. One up, one down.
The first baseman, number 22, Josh Naylor.
Here's Josh Naylor. Doubled his first time up.
As a batter, he's known for performing better in these night games. He might start 2-for-2 in this one.
Line drive, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Wasting no time. He's
now
2-for-2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Now it's Jose Ramirez. Runner takes off. And that one wrapped foul. Naylor over at first with one away. Fought off foul. And downstairs. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Oh, really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike pitch right there. At worst-case scenario, it's weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
David Fry digs in now. He drove it 2 with a double his first time up. Swings and misses. 1-1.
0-1's the count. Ball
in the dirt, blocked, and an excellent job keeping it right there. Here comes a pitch, fights that one away. Still 1-2. another ball. Broken bat, roll to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. One left for the Guardians. They're up 2-0. Set for the bottom of the third. Here's Miguel
Andujar. The designated hitter, Miguel Andujar.
And the pitch. Oh, he doesn't get the call. And that is ball one. And that one fouled off. One, one now. Ground ball up the middle. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. No throw, and they don't get it out on the play. Jordan Diaz up next for the A's. The first pitch misses for ball one. The Guardians up by two as we play game one of this four-game series. Next offering is in for a strike. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Next pitch is outside. It's a good take. Two, two now. Next offering is outside.
He's really tightening up his hitting zone with two strikes here. I love it.
And he deals. And that's ball four.
That's ball four.
Oh, now he's got two runners on after that walk.
Batting none.
Thinks he can get out of hand in a hurry in these situations. So he's going to have to find a way to get back into the strike zone.
And let Miss Diaz now. Out to short. And it finds its way through for a hit. And they're happy to play station to station right here. Bases loaded. Nobody out.
Wasted no time there. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock, and you'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole.
So the lineup flips over. Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Esteyuri Ruiz. That one finds the zone. That's strike one. The Guardians leading by two here in the last half of the third. Slider misses outside.
You need a strikeout, and you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play, or get yourself a pop-up, something, but you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
Brings it in. One away.
Oh, that's a frustrating at bat right there. Now big opportunity and just missed it. And then he wanted to do some damage. Next guy, pick him up.
Ryan Noda up next for the A's. Golden opportunity right here. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Close, but called a ball, and it's 2-0.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count, base is loaded. You don't want to fall to a three-ball count and then walk in a run. He's got to challenge the hitter right here.
Fouled off. He was late. A Andujar at third. Diaz on second. Diaz at first. One gone. Foul back our way, and that's out of play.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Kicks and deals.
That's outside.
And it's a full count.
Recognize that changeup right out of her hand. Just spit on it.
Ball four. And a run comes in to score.
Really got himself into a mess out there and now forces home a run with the wall. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
One down.
No,
Zach Gelo. Up next for the A's. There.
Good layoff and pitch down.
And a pop up right side, foul territory. And there's two away. Stepping in the long ball, Brent Rooker. Grounded out his first time up. Not even close there. And that's ball one.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
Loaded up, dangerous hitter at the plate. And now two balls and a strike.
Look, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
And the pitch. And that one fouled off. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And the slider just misses.
A really good take, especially with two strikes.
And the righty deals. He fouls it off. We'll do it again. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout. So they get one, but end up leaving the bases loaded. On to inning number four. It's the Guardians 2 and the A's 1. And welcome back to the ballpark. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Bo Naylor. The right-hander back to work. Ball. That misses the zone. Ball one. Right through there for a strike. And now 2-1. That one missing inside.
You know, these Guardians showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
This one popped up. Foul ground first base side. He's there. He's got it. And there's one away.
Now batting the second baseman, Andres Jimenez.
Here's Andres Jimenez. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there's certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team.
Oh, and a nice sliding stop. Nicely done for the out.
But he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Laureano.
Here's Ramon Laureano. He's 0 for 1. Strike 1.
0 and 1.
Cleveland up a run looking for more. Swing and a miss.
No ball, two strikes.
Two outs.
One ball.
Squirts away a little bit. He's in there. And on the wild pitch, he goes down to third.
Well, that right there can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball's gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it because you're already in scoring position. Well, he was sure there, and now he's only 90 feet away from scoring.
Righty to the plate. Fouls it back with two strikes. The pitch. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. The 2-2 now. Switch through that one. It's a strikeout. No runs on no hits, no errors, and one man left. To the bottom of inning number 4 now. It's the Guardians 2 and the A's 1. Back in Oakland. Now here is Seth Brown.
The left fielder.
As he turns on the rubber, here with that good live arm delivers. Pitches in there. That's strike one. And a foul ball left side.
Well, this is a good time to step out of the box, take a deep breath, reset. A couple of changeups. Probably won't see another one here.
And the 0-2. And that's outside. Swings and misses. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. And here's the catcher, Tyler Soderstrom. 0 for 1, he grounded out in his first at bat. Hard ground ball, base knock. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. Yeah,
wasn't able to elevate that one, but he sure hit it hard enough to get through the infield. There's not a whole lot of time for the defenders to react and try to make a play when it's ripped like that.
Now the A's designated hitter, Miguel Andujar, reached on an infield single his first time. Runner on the goal. Here's a rocket out to left. Drops into the glove, and there are two outs.
Now batting, third baseman, Jordan Diaz.
Jordan Diaz, up next for the A's. He reached on a walk his first time.
Boog, the runner at first needs to be careful right here. He's dealing with the pickoff artist on the mound.
Just missed.
That's inside.
The pitch. And another ball. Bounce to the left side. To first. And that is the inning. One left for Oakland. They're down 2-1. And we're back. New inning getting started. Now the left fielder, Stephen Kwan. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. And a pitch. That's in there. Strike one.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
And a swing and a miss there. Sandy, one of the things that's interesting is that guys really don't worry about swing and miss from an offensive standpoint anymore. So when you see somebody who contacts the ball like this, do you think of that as plus value?
Absolutely. If he's doing damage now, if he's rolling over and grounding out, then it's a different story. But, yeah, he can put the ball in the gaps or over the fence 100%.
Now a screamer into the outfield. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. And up next for Cleveland, Miles Straw. Inside corner, that's a strike. It's 0-1.
He's been going after these guys consistently, and as a result, he's been able to keep his pitch count low, throwing the ball very well right now.
Just off the outside edge. One ball, one strike. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the fifth. And that's a little bit high. 2-1. One down, base is empty.
Three.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. Down two away. Chris, third time through the order, and a couple of quick outs for the starter.
Yeah, he's been very frugal today. Economical with the pitch count.
And now it's Josh Naylor. Naylor goes 5'11", 250 pounds, and he was born in Canada. First offering, and it just misses. That's in for a strike. And here comes. Bounce to third. Diaz. Guardians go down in order. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Guardians 2 and the A's 1. Bottom of the inning, and it's a Aledmys Diaz.
A shortstop. Aledmys Diaz.
pitch. And that's in there at the knees for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes usually doesn't work out for success. But you can never predict baseball.
And the right-hander deals. Pitch misses there. 1-2 to count.
That's a really good job of laying off the 0-2 high fastball. It's going to make that pitcher really have to respect this hitter, even though he's behind in the count.
The 1-2. That one drifts inside.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Slider misses outside. Este Yuri Ruiz up next. Three, two down. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter or two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. Bob, he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Up to bat next, lays off for a ball.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
On the ground a second, might be two. Off balance beat, there's one. Not in time at first, it's a fielder's choice.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
Ryan Noda now at the plate. Runner on the goal. Pitch inside. Open second, and that was not close.
Well, nights like this when it seems harder to score, I like the ball to put him in motion and try to steal the base. Ball's not carrying, no home run so far, so trying to maybe capture some offense like this may be the way to go.
And it's second. And fouled off.
Pretty good pitch to take a pass at in a 1-0 count. Just not able to square it up.
There's a swing and a miss.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Now a miss.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
Steps on first for the out.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Zach Gallen up next for the A's. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Well, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
Towards first, and that chance handled. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. The A's strand one, and they trail it here, 2-1. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Here's the third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
And a pitch.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. Kind of shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Tonight, his slider has been really impressive. I mean, tight spin. Seems like the hitters aren't picking it up out of the hand.
Righty delivers. The punch out there. One gone here.
Tunneled that pitch. Thought it was going to be a slider breaking in off the plate, but it hugged the corner. And at that point, when he recognized it, it was just too late.
David Fry digs in for the Guardians. Drove in two runs on a double back in the first. He's one for two. It's softly on the ground left side. Zips it across. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Deceptive now slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel catcher. A long time. Got that hitter out front. Rolled over it. Put Naylor. It on the ground.
Bo Naylor at the plate now. Close, but called a ball. And that's ball one. There's a strike.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Two down, nobody on. And we're the top half of the sixth. And now one and two. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Two down, nobody on. On the ground, right side. Fires over to first. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Nothing doing for the offense that time. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Guardians 2 and the A's 1. And welcome back to the ballpark. Well, we go bottom right six. Here. Here's the Oakland cleanup hitter, Brent Rooker. Fiving back to work. Just missed. And a good eye there. Everyone finds the zone, and it's 2-1.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection.
Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. And there's one down.
Now batter, left fielder.
Here's the left fielder, Seth Brown. Foul ball there. Here comes the 0-1. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Catcher tosses the mask, settles under it, pulls it down, and there's two gone.
Now batting, catcher.
So digging in, Tyler Soderstrom, one for two. Here's a strike.
Backdoored him with a breaking ball. Just got the corner. There's nothing you can really do with that.
And that one upstairs. The pitch. And a foul ball. Left-hand hitter waits. Bounced up the middle. Sends it to first. Three up, three down, inning over. No runs, no hits, no errors. We're through six full. It's the Guardians 2 and the A's 1. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, number 14. And this is the best way to make your major league debut. No one on base.
Yeah, you're already going to be a little nervous out there. So I think it's a nice job by the skipper to get him in here without any added pressure with traffic on the bases.
Here's Brian Rocchio.
Well, both sides equally as strong. So not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. Diaz calls it in, and there's one away.
Up next for Cleveland, the second baseman, Andrés.
So in now for Cleveland, Andrés Giménez. And that gets the top of the zone for a strike. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Trevor Gott preparing to come on if needed. The wind of the pitch.
One
delivers
ball, one
outside. Strike. One down, base is empty. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The pitch.
Ball.
Well, he might have to look for a different put-away pitch right here, too, too. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at-bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Up the middle, Gallo. Over to first, and two away to start the seventh.
The right fielder, number 10, Ramon.
And now the right fielder, Laureano. Ramon Laureano. That clips the corner. Clips the corner.
He doesn't seem to like the pitch up. Hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
And he deals.
One
and
ball.
A curve misses two outside. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And it's a 3-up, 3-down inning. Guardians fail to score as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Back here in the East Bay, now it's the DH, Miguel Andujar. Line to the pitch. In for a strike. And it's 0-1. Action in the pen down there. Scott Barlow getting ready to go. Henches getting loose as well. Looking to get the tying run on base. Fought off foul. The 0-2. And the tying run is on with a leadoff single.
Everything came together for him. I can roll base hits like that one all day long, and so can every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Tanner Bibee departs, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. Guardians going with a new pitcher, now Nick Sandlin.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
No outs, runner at first. Digging in for Oakland, Jordan Diaz. That one finds the zone. That's strike one.
You're a base runner. You got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Kicks and fires. Fouled off. He was late.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Struck him out looking.
Well, this is no secret. That slider is going to be his go-to pitch. Everyone in the ballpark knows it. It's a massive part of his arsenal, and he'll throw a lot and in pretty much any count, any situation, and he's going to look to punch guys out as well. I tell you what, the effectiveness of that slider is always a big key for him.
Aledmys Diaz now. And a base hit. They fired it quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
Oh, just a nice job on the board. Pretty high leverage spot right there. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball, let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit. Now a pretty big at bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
Out to center field. Brings it in, and there are two down.
Up next to Oakland, the first baseman, Ryan Noda.
So first and second with two outs. Ryan Noda up next for the A's. Immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. And that's off the inside edge. And it's a ball and a strike. Two on, two outs. And that one fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Foul ball still, one and two count. Big spot, two outs. Both the tying and go-ahead runs are aboard here, the bottom of the seventh. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building. So the tying run at second. Fastball almost got him there.
Straightened him up a little bit.
Here comes a pitch. Line drive, base hit. Now a long throw home. And he's safe. Tie ball game.
Such great concentration. Everybody on their feet. Knowing that you can come through with a good swing, but there he doesn't try to do too much.
Here's the second baseman, Zach Gelof. Little chopper rolls foul. Next pitch is outside. And another ball. Trying to keep this a 2-2 game as we play game one of this four-game series. In the air, right field. Laureano sizing this one up. Makes the play, and it's out number three. So one run in the inning on this base hit. 2-2 game. Back in Oakland, now the left fielder, Stephen Kwan.
Leading off for the Guardian, the left fielder,
and a pitch.
Kwan.
Fought off foul. The pitch. Center field, Ruiz, under this one. And out number one on the ground. Miles Straw digs in for the Guardians. 0 for 3 with two strikeouts and a ground out. Right through there for a strike.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Activity in the bullpen. Mason Miller up and throwing. Medina also getting ready. All tied up, and we're at the top of the eighth. Swing and a ball popped up. And that'll fall for a base hit.
Well, he didn't get much of that one, but it's going to look like a line drive in the box score ball. Just a flare down that right field line, and he got it to drop in fair. I guarantee you, he was yelling, get down, as he ran out of the box because, Boog, sometimes you just got to talk to him. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Naylor in the box now, takes strike one. And the 0-1. And there's a ball.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
One away. Tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. And there's the strike. Kicks and deals. Ground ball to the right side. Goes to second for one. Return for the first down. Double play. And that'll do it. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. Home half of inning number eight straight ahead. We are tied 2-2. Now the pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, James Karinchak.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
So here's the cleanup hitter for Oakland, Brent Rooker. Outfield deep here, tried to prevent anything over their heads. And a pitch. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. That's off the mark. One and one. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
One ball, two strikes.
Pitches outside. We'll chase that time. Seth Brown in the on deck circle for the A's. Payoff pitch. Right side. Laureano trying to get there. He's got it. One up, one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play.
2013 in the playoffs, you caught one as the Red Sox played the Rays in the division series.
I sacrificed a bracelet. It was my wrist and my hand.
And ball one.
That's a really good take.
Cleveland has some action going in their pen. Eli Morgan appears to be getting loose. One down, base is empty.
That's
and another ball. At the belt and fires.
That
one misses, and it's 3-2. Left-hand batter waits. Got him! And there's two away.
Well, just ripped a page out of the Greg Maddux playbook. Throw that pitch at the hip and just watch it jump back over the inside part of the plate. I'll tell you what, you are baffled expecting that to almost hit you and then end up as a called strike.
And now here's the A's catcher, Tyler Soderstrom. 1-for-3. That one finds the zone.
0-1.
Karinchak, 28 years old, and he was a ninth round draft pick back in 2017. And the righty deals. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. Up to the left into foul ground, drifts towards it, nabs it, and that'll do it. Nothing across here this half. Ninth inning coming up. We are tied 2-2. We go to the ninth. Now the four-hole hitter for the Guardians, Jose Ramirez. The right-hander back to work. And that one clips the corner.
That was just paint on the first pitch fastball.
That one off the mark. And a count even 1-1. Swings and lines one towards the gap. And no one can get there. In safely with a leadoff double, go-ahead runs in scoring position.
Now always feels amazing getting the job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. Man, that feels so good to shoot an absolute bolt the opposite way. Split the gap and know that you've got extra bases right off the bat. That's the kind of thing hitters dream about when they're falling asleep at night. A lot riding on this next at bat now as they look to take the lead at a critical point this one.
Fry in the box now. Takes strike one. With the go-ahead run standing at second here at the top of the ninth. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
He's falling behind in a huge spot, Boo. Got to do what it takes to come through. Maybe choke up on the bat a little bit, spread out those feet. Whatever it takes.
And it's second. Just off the inside corner. And the count 1-2. The pitch. Chopped to the ground. Fires over to first.
barely got him for the out close play.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at bat.
And now the catcher comes up to him. Bo Naylor. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
Oh, definitely one. A strikeout situation right here. Lots of ways for that go-ahead run to score if the ball's put in play.
And a pitch. Popped in the air. Left field. Squeezes it. Here comes the runner from third. The throw is offline. He's safe. It's 3-2.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job, and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play, and a nice job with the sack fly.
Stands in now and watches strike one.
He didn't want to give up that run, but he did. Got the fly ball, sack fly out. Now it's time to attack these other guys. Get your team back in the dugout.
Curveball drops in there. The Athletics have some bullpen action. Trevor Gott getting loose out there. Swing and a miss. Curveball in the dirt. In time. So the drop third strike doesn't hurt him. And that's that. One run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on. Bottom part of the order, 7-8-9, two up in inning number 9. Guardians 3 and the A's 2. Welcome back, and here comes the closer, Emmanuel Clase. A chance at his first save of the year.
Now pitching for the Guardians, number 48, Emmanuel Clase.
Well, one run game, Miguel Andujar getting ready to hit.
Miguel.
What are you looking to do in these spots? You're down a run. You're leading off the inning.
He's not a power hitter, a guy that's looking to tie it up with one swing. So he's going to take and get into this at bat and try to get deep into the bat. Ultimately, however he can, get to first base.
Makes the grab, and there's one down.
Now batting, third baseman, showdown.
He's two outs away. Next up for the A's, Jordan Diaz.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
There's a strike.
Well, so many hard throwing relievers in the game these days, you would think that hitters have made the adjustment, but I don't know if you ever get used to it. Just pumping gas out of the bullpen. So hard to play catch up.
And here it comes. Back our way, and that's out of play. One down, base is empty, and another ball. Two now. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Crowd locked in right now. One-run game here in the ninth. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Swing and a miss, and they're down to their last out. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get out. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
The Athletics down to their last out. Oledmys Diaz up next for the A's. And foul off. They're down to their final strike. A one-run lead. We're in the last half of the ninth inning. Hit to right, and that ought to do it. And that'll do it. The Guardians take the season opener and move to 1-0.
Well, you take a tie ball game into the ninth.